Hello everybody, my name is Today and you are so much welcome to my channel. Yes. Okay, let's try this. Hello everybody, I hope you're having great time in this winter saying goodbye time. Probably, yeah. Anyway, I want to show you something regarding photos. And yeah, I'm not gonna show you how I take photos, how to do, you know, what equipment do I use. Let's save this for some other time. I will show you how I edit photos. I sometimes use Lightroom, I sometimes use Photoshop. If I have to add something to a photo, I use Photoshop. It's so much echo in this room. Oh my god. Well, what I'm using beside Lightroom, but wait. First, yeah, I almost forgot this. It's 2 Minute Tuesday. So let's roll this clock now. Are we ready? Are you ready for rolling this clock now? Let's go together. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bam! Interesting. Anyway, yeah, you can go away now. Anyway, I recommend you to use just an easy, quick software. It's available for Mac, it's available for Windows and Linux. It's very, very easy to use, and it's quite, it has all the functions you need, actually. It's called Polarr Photo Editor, or Polarr Photo Editor, Polarr, I'm not quite sure how to pronounce this. You have free version and pro version. I'm using pro version. You could easily use that free version. So let's go and jump into the computer that is right down under the camera. Bam! Let's go! I have this beautiful photo of Dubrovnik here open on my computer screen. Right click on it, open this with photo editor. The first time when you will launch it, you will get some tips and tricks how to use it, where are all the tools that you're going to use. So on the left side, these are the filters. On the right side of the screen, you have all the tools. Let me just close this. This is the tool to cut the picture. So let's start now with adjustments that are first thing that you will do when you will adjust a photo. This photo is a little bit, it's not straight, right? Just click on this tool here and then you have this rotation circle here. And you can use this circle to rotate it manually, or you can leave it to make it automatically. So let's rotate it. Let's align it with tower here. So that's it. That's probably it. If you want to apply this, you just click on it and that's it. It's applying, and I will get rid of also this wall here because it's in our way. We don't need that, so let's put it like this. We have much more likable photo now, but anyway, something is missing. It's plain photo, no depth in it. Let's go to this. Adjustments, and first thing I will do, I will use light. First thing I am ever touching when going to edit a photo is shadows. Shadows and blacks. So I will just move these shadows up. The forest is going to be much more visible. And then I will just a little bit of blacks, not much, because it's already washed out colors. And highlights. I don't need so much of this highlights here. So I usually close highlights very, very much. Whites, yeah, I think that we can close the whites also because it's very bright photo. Because we adjust the blacks and shadows, we lost a little bit of contrast. So now I need to add some contrast in this photo. So I will just add it something about 22. So let's go to coloring. I need to add some more vivid, more life to this photo. So I will use vibrance for this. I usually do something like 22, 25, 26 of vibrance and a bit of saturation, not much, it's just like 5, 6, something like that. Let's put it like here 7, just to get much more red and other colors that are much more bright, much more stronger out in the photo. So this is it, that's actually looking much better. Here you have icon, you can go check before and after, and this is before and this is after, much difference already. We can use some details, clarity. Don't use too much of this. Let's just kick this clarity a little bit, not too much. Something like 14, 15, 16, something like that. Sharpen it a bit, not much. Let's go to curves. I usually use like wide curves. I pump up a little bit of upper third of this and I close just slightly under the line here a little bit of black, a little bit of dark parts of the photo here, so we get much more depth in the photo. That's it, because it was very, very hot in that day, so I will just pump the temperature to the warm side. Yeah, that's more like it. It's much more live, a live photo, right? That's it. When we want to save it, we just click on this upper icon here and just click on it. You have here the option also to put the quality. What quality would you like to save? Low, medium, high, best. I'm always saving as best quality. If I want to resize the photo, I can do also this. I can do also batch resizing if I want to. So I will now just save it like this and save a copy, and that's it. And here it is, this is the screen where that is asking me, where do you want to save my photo, man? Yeah, I want to save it like here. That's all. You got the photo edited perfectly as you like. You can just play with the settings a bit so the photo will be, you know, that you will like the photo here, right? So, if you like the photo as I did, and if you like the video, you know what you have to do, right? Just click on that like button here. Under there, there's a button to subscribe. Just hit that button to subscribe to my channel, so you will have much more of that kind of videos in your email inbox, right? That's it. Well, I have to stop now because 2 minutes are already gone. I failed for this 2 minutes, but who counts, right? Who counts? I don't count. Just leave me a comment, whatever you want to see in the next 2 minute Tuesday, and yeah, I'll probably do it, yeah. I hope that I have shown you something useful here, and that's it, yeah. This is now for 2 minute Tuesday, and see you in the next video. Bye.